Hey fitness friends, Coach Andres here with the Strength Cave. In this video, I'm gonna talk to you guys about how you can use diet breaks to make your diet easier and more effective. No matter how motivated you are to lose some fat, there comes a point in every diet where you're just plain tired of feeling hungry all the time. With no end in sight, you might break down and have yourself a cheat meal, or even worse, stop dieting altogether. But what if there was a way to stop this from happening? What if there was a way to structure your diet so that you didn't have to endure that feeling for very long, and that by doing so, you might actually lose more fat over time? Well, guess what? There is a way to do that. It's called diet breaks, and it's become sort of a secret weapon that a lot of people are using to lose weight and suffer less through the process. Real quick, before I forget, do me a favor, subscribe to this channel if you're watching on YouTube. If you're watching on Instagram, give me a like and a follow, and let me know what other types of topics you want me to cover in future videos. So just like it sounds, a diet break is sort of like a pause on your diet that usually lasts about 1 to 2 weeks. During the diet break, you would increase your calorie intake up to your maintenance level, which is usually quite a bit higher than the calories that you've been dieting on. Obviously, since you're at maintenance during your diet break, you're not going to lose any weight. But the point of a diet break isn't to lose weight. Instead, the point is to give you a little bit of relief from the dieting process and to provide sort of a light at the end of the tunnel that you could look to when the dieting is going a little bit rough. That way, you remain steadfast in your conviction to stick to the diet and you don't give in to those cravings and stress that come with dieting. But diet breaks don't just provide a mental benefit. There is actually some really good science to back them up too. The Matador study, which compared the outcomes of continuous dieting versus diet breaks, found that those in the diet break group were able to lose more fat, retain more muscle, and maintain a higher metabolism than those in the continuous dieting group. This study was done on men and used a 2 week on, 2 week off approach for the diet break group. More recently, the ice cap study compared similar outcomes, except they studied women and their diet break group used a 3 weeks on, 1 week off approach. In this study, they found that the diet break group and the continuous dieting group lost the same amount of fat and maintained the same level of metabolism as each other. However, they did find that hunger was much lower and that diet satisfaction was much higher in the diet break group. Taking these two studies together, it seems that diet breaks can help you to lose more fat, retain more muscle, maintain a higher metabolism, and also help you to feel less hungry and more satisfied throughout the dieting process. Practically speaking, I find it really useful to use diet breaks with my clients because it helps me to schedule in things like vacations, holidays, and birthdays. If you schedule your diet breaks to coincide with these sort of events, then you can still enjoy yourself during those times without messing up your diet. Also, I think that diet breaks work really well for people who are trying to maintain a higher level of performance while dropping some body fat. If you've dieted in the past, then you're probably familiar with the fact that dieting can make you feel pretty trashed at the gym. With diet breaks, I find that my clients are able to maintain their poor performance a lot more easily, and I can line up their diet break with the most intense parts of their training cycles. This not only helps them make more gains, but it also allows them to continue training hard without having to deload quite as often. To be fair, diet breaks aren't all positive. There are some drawbacks that you may not like. For one, dieting this way means that reaching your fat loss goal is going to take you a longer amount of time compared to continuous dieting. Let's say you wanted to lose 20 pounds at a rate of 1 pound loss per week. With continuous dieting, this would take you about 20 to 25 weeks, depending on how your metabolism responded. With diet breaks, this could take you upwards of 40 weeks to lose those 20 pounds. So you do have to be a bit more patient with the diet break method. Another drawback might be that you could find it difficult to maintain your momentum with your diet. You might find it hard to get back into the dieting mindset following a break, which would then sort of decrease the effectiveness of the diet itself. So if these things sound like too much of a hassle for you, then diet breaks may not be the best option. But if diet breaks still sound like your thing, then you probably want to know how to implement them. I believe that a 1 to 2 week break is probably the sweet spot when it comes to how long the diet break should last. Less than a week doesn't seem to be quite as effective, but more than 2 weeks seems to be a little bit too much as far as maintaining that dieting momentum. And a frequency of about 2 to 8 weeks is probably pretty good for most people. If you're pretty good at dieting for longer stretches of time without feeling the pain, or you feel like you just need to gain more momentum before you take a diet break, then you may want to do one every 6 to 8 weeks. But if you tend to get hangry really quickly during a diet, then it may be better for you to implement a diet break every 2 to 4 weeks. And of course, the big question that you may have is how many calories you should be eating on your diet break. As I mentioned before, you want to bring your calories up to your maintenance level. But depending on how long you've been dieting, your maintenance calories may have changed. If you plan to take a diet break every 2 weeks, then you can just go back to the same calories you were eating before the diet because your metabolism wouldn't have changed very much in that time, and so your maintenance should be about the same. But if you're going to go longer stretches between diet breaks, say 6 to 8 weeks, then you may need to do a little bit of calculation because your metabolism will likely have changed. The best way to do this would be to figure out how much weight you've lost over the last 2 to 3 weeks based on your average weight each week, and then compare it to your caloric intake throughout that time. For example, let's say that between weeks 6 and 8, you lost 1.3 pounds. That equates to about 4,000 to 4,500 calories, depending on how conservative you're trying to be. Doing the math, this turns out to be about 285 to 320 calories as your daily caloric deficit. If you had averaged, say, 1,550 calories throughout those 2 weeks of dieting, then your maintenance calories would be around 1,835 to 1,870 calories. After your diet break, you can either go back down to 1,550 calories or drop it down a little bit lower, depending on how fast you want to lose weight. Then the next time you implement another diet break, you'd simply do that math all over again and just keep doing it until eventually you'll reach your fat loss goal. All right, guys, so diet breaks are an exciting new strategy that a lot of people can use to make their dieting process easier and more effective. Overall, if you can deal with the fact that it may take you longer to lose the weight, then it seems that diet breaks are a home run if you want to lose fat and keep it off for good. I hope you enjoyed this video. Thanks so much for watching. If you're not already, make sure you're subscribed to this YouTube channel and that you're following me on Instagram. I hope you guys are having a wonderful day, and I'll catch you guys next time.